Bring your A Game Sports Talk Radio. And I'm live right here in the player spot doing my thing right here on this Friday. It's been a good Friday, man, and I've been enjoying myself, man. It's nice outside. It's going to be nice this weekend. We got NCAA basketball going on, man. We down to four teams now. Four teams. It's been a wild and crazy, man. It's been a wild, crazy tournament, but I've been enjoying it, man. I mean, game after game, you had the Big Ten representing well. You had the SEC, they was representing well. The ACC, they still got a dog in the fight, man. We just gonna talk, man. You got MSU versus Texas Tech, number two and number three. You got Auburn versus Virginia, number five versus number one. Man, it goes down Saturday tomorrow, man. And I got my cousin on the phone. Chad Belly, what's going on, man?
What you?
Not much, man. Joe, NCAA basketball. How you been enjoying it, man? We down to four teams now. Is it what you expected, or has it been a disaster? What you think?
Last weekend was a disaster.
Why you say that?
North Carolina, Kentucky, supposed to be there.
Oh, man, whatever, man. They lost. I mean, they lost. You know, those was two young teams, and from what we see, it's the veteran teams that's in it. You got Michigan State as a veteran team. You got Texas Tech, which is their first time in the Final Four. They're a team that's been put together that's got experience together. You got Auburn and Virginia. You know, Virginia, they always there at the number one slot. And Auburn, this is their first time. Now, this is Virginia's first time in the Final Four in about 85 years. I mean, how can you say they supposed to be there? I feel like experience is there. That's the reason why they there.
Okay.
And that's all you're going to say is okay.
What? Hello?
I'm still here. I'm listening to you.
I guess so.
Whatever, Weasel. But anyway. I'm moving on.
I guess so. It's alright, though.
Whatever, man. But anyway, we down to the Final Four teams, man. I got my cousin Weasel on the phone, man. We're going to talk NCAA basketball. We're going to see what the two teams he going to pick that's going to move forward and go ahead and play in the championship, and I'm going to see who he's going to pick, and then we're going to write it down. Y'all see it on the board, post it all across on the social media sites, on your Facebook, on the Instagram. It's Black Hippie. Go ahead and look a player up. Plus, I'm giving away a free T-shirt today, man. Trivia question. So, Weezy, you going to be on the phone with me all day today, man?
Yeah.
All right, then. We live right now, so we live across the air, Weezy, so watch what you say, man. Nah, I'm just messing with you. Say whatever you want to say. It's BHIE Live. I'm your host, the Black Hippie. We sitting right here in the player spot, me and my cousin. Jelly Belly Telly is what I call him. But around the way, in the hood, they call him Weasel in Boston. We're going to talk NCAA Final Four basketball. I got Michigan State. That's all I'm going to say. Be back with y'all in a minute. Here's Oz and Damian Marley on the road to Zion. We live, Weasel. We live, all right?
reputation without a doubt. Don't make them take you like who them took out. Jah will be waiting there, we a shout. Jah will be waiting there. Clean and pure meditation without a doubt. Don't make them take you like who them took out. Jah will be waiting there, we a shout. Jah will be waiting there. You got to keep on walking. On the road to Zion.
Can't help but feel helpless. I'm having daymares at daytime, wide awake, try to relate. This can't be happening like I'm in a dream while I'm walking. Cause what I'm seeing is haunting. Human beings like ghosts and zombies. President Mugabe holding guns to innocent bodies in Zimbabwe. They make John Pope seem godly, sacrilegious and blasphemous. In my lifetime, I look back at paths I walk where savages fought and pastors taught. Prostitutes stomping high heel boots. Badges scream at young black children, stop or I will shoot. I look back and cook crack, plush cars that pass by. Jaguars, mad fly, and I'm guilty for materialism. Blacks are still up in the prison, trust that. So save me your sorries, I'm raising an army. Revolutionary warfare with Damian Marley. We sparking the irons, marching the Zion. You know how Nas be, NYC state of mind I'm in.
In this world of calamity, dirty looks and grudges and jealousy. And police way abuse their majority. Media clowns when I know about variety. Single parents will need some charity. Youths will need some love and prosperity. Instead of broken dreams and tragedy. By any plan and any means and strategy. Say, I got to keep on walking. On the road to Zion. Dirty looks and grudges and jealousy. And police way abuse their majority. Media clowns when I know about variety. Single parents will need some charity. Youths will need some love and prosperity. Instead of broken dreams and tragedy. By any plan and any means and strategy. Instead of broken dreams and tragedy. Youths will need some love and prosperity. Instead of broken dreams and tragedy. By any plan and any means and any strategy. Hey, say. You got to keep on walking on the road to Zion, man.
Bring your A-Game Sports Talk Radio. I'm your host, the Black Hippie, and we live across the air right now, sitting back talking to my cousin, my homie. I could call him my big brother, even though he used to bully me sometime. I ain't going to lie to you. Don't let his old fat self fool you. But we're sitting back.
I'm lying to the people, man.
You did used to bully
me. I'm lying
to the people. Man, all right, whatever, man. But we sitting back, man. We sitting back. We talking NCAA basketball, man. Me and my homie, man. Like I say, we down to four teams. We down to Texas Tech, Michigan State, Auburn, Virginia. Now, I know you said earlier, Weasel, that you think that North Carolina and Kentucky should have still been in there. Why you feel that way?
They
should have
been in the same bracket.
So you think
they had no business being in the same bracket.
So you think they had the brackets all wrong?
I think they should have set up just in case. I think the NCAA had it set up just in case Duke got there. They wouldn't have to face nobody really.
I mean, but Duke had a tough road. You know, they had a tough road with UCF, and they also had a tough going with who else did they bet? Was that Florida State they played against? Am I wrong or right?
I'm not quite sure. Who did Duke end up losing? Oh, Michigan State.
Duke ended up losing to Michigan State. But they had a tough road. They didn't run into no teams that they really got a pushover on, except in that first round, I would think. But I would say even going across that way with Michigan State, Duke had a nice little tough road. I got to give them credit where credit due. They fought, but at the same time, you know, they got a little help. You know, this not no Duke. They did fight. You know, I got to give Zion his credit, man. Zion hoop, man. I got to give it to him. We're going to talk about him later on, too, because he still ain't announced if he going to go or not. Plus, he also said that he might stick around because he ain't like that loss. So, I think he won the NCAA championship ring. But, no, we're going to talk about that later on. But, yeah, I mean, Duke didn't have such an easy road. This NCAA tournament, I would say, is by far, like, one of the best. It's got to be ranked up there with one of the best because night in and night out, you didn't know who was going to win. You know, I mean, North Carolina had a few blowouts, you know. But it ain't you really didn't look at it in each bracket, in each region, and was like, damn, man, my bracket ain't going to be safe after this second round. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, I mean, how did you like, how what you think about the NCAA tournament this year?
It was all right.
That's it?
Just wish that John Morant could have played longer.
Well, I wish he could have too, but you know, that whole thing with Murray State, they have a nice team, but Ja Morant is the playmaker. You get what I'm saying? He's the playmaker. And I mean, the other players they have the skill, they have the ability to go ahead and, you know, get theirs, but I think what the other team did, they say they like, okay, Ja gonna get his regardless, but we gonna play defense on them and make them really work. I think it was just a better strategy. I think it was just a better strategy by the other team. You know, they got out coached. You know, just like with St. Louis, because I had St. Louis meeting up with Duke and knocking Duke out because I really think they would have. St. Louis went outside their game, and they went outside their game. They started shooting threes. And that's not their game. They won inside and on the defensive side with the defensive rebounding and the offensive rebounding points in the paint. That was St. Louis' game, and they went outside of that, and they were shooting threes. And that's how UCF beat them. You get what I'm saying? But, yeah. I mean, it was just proper game planning. You know, who did Murray State play? Oh, my God. I can't believe I don't know who Murray State played.
Florida
State. Huh?
Florida State.
Yeah, okay. Florida State. But yeah, I mean, like, you know, you just got to look at it like that. It was a better game plan, you know? Ja, he going to the league, so I think that's the best deal for him in his sophomore year. I think he done showed enough that he more than ready. You get what I'm saying? And,
right.
I mean, it is what it is. I wish I could have saw Ja play longer, too, but you look at the game, man. It was just a better game plan. It wasn't that Murray State was a bad team. It was just a better coaching, better game plan. That's it. That's all.
I want to see Ja Morant at the UC. That's where I want to see him at.
You know, if the Bulls got to get that lottery pick, are they going? I mean, even if they don't get that lottery pick, they got some nice assets to trade up to get Ja Morant. You get what I'm saying? Because what teams you got? Who is at the bottom of the barrel? That's what I need to figure out. Who at the bottom of the barrel?
Phoenix.
And Ja Morant might be a good fit in Phoenix though, Weasel.
The Lakers.
Yeah.
Sacramento.
Mm-hmm.
Charlotte. Yeah.
But out of all them teams, What is his best fit?
I think his best fit is in.
Don't forget, you got.
Phoenix or Chicago.
You forgot the name New York. New York in the mix.
The Knicks hoping on getting that number one pick.
Yeah, you got
and I already know who New York don't need another point guard. They got four of them. They got three of them over there.
Hey, but Ja Morant is a different type of animal. Trade them away, use them as assets, and build your team up. I mean, New York ain't seen no good basketball in a while, so why not?
I still say you already got somebody like Ja Morant over there.
Who they point guard?
Dennis.
Oh, you got Dennis
Smith Jr.
Oh, you got Dennis Smith Jr. over there. Okay.
So.
Oh, and you got.
I like Ja Morant.
And you got Monday over there.
Yeah.
Emmanuel
Mudiay.
Yeah, he over there.
And you got Frank Elicina, the friend, the boy from France.
Oh, the 6'6 guy?
So, I think that's how tall he is. I'm not quite sure.
Okay, yeah.
So, you got enough point guards over there. New York needs a big man.
So, who is a big man that's coming out of college right now that will fit that number one pick since Zion is still like, on the wire? We know Ja Morant coming out, and it's a possibility he could be a number one. Or, I mean, they could draft Ja Morant and trade away a Mudiay or either Dennis Smith Jr. And keep the guy and keep the 6'6 guard that you was talking about from France and build from there. And go get them a big guy. Go get them a big guy that's out there that's going to be available. I mean, like, I don't know. Maybe you could. I mean, you got DeMarcus Cousins that's on a 1-year contract. You know, you got Kevin Durant that's lingering out there. So that might be something good to show and put out there. I mean, I wouldn't necessarily say that would be out of the question that Ja Morant would go to New York.
But I don't know what Kyrie gonna do either.
True.
Kyrie been talking to New York.
But you got Kyrie that's already like broken down. He already like a 05 Benz right now, man. He got high mileage. You know, he's still good. He'll still get you where you're going, but you know, he might have to park him a few days, you know, and don't put too many more miles on him, because you don't want that bill to be too expensive on you if it break all the way the fuck down. You get what I'm saying? Why would you want to take that chance?
I'm saying, guess what, Kia? You still don't know what Kyrie and Kevin Durant are gonna do.
Right.
I think wherever one of them go, the other one don't follow.
I don't know.
And I read an article today that Kevin Durant to the Knicks is a done deal. Now, if that's a done deal, more than likely he's bringing Kyrie with him.
I don't
know. So why you go out and get Ja Morant when you already got Dennis Smith Jr. there, and Mudiay, and the other guy?
They're good assets, Weasel. I just said that. They're good assets. Nothing is guaranteed in this business of the NBA, this corporation of the NBA. Let's just keep it real.
Right.
Nothing is guaranteed, man. It ain't like just because you got Dennis Smith Jr. You had Dennis Smith Jr. that was down there in Dallas doing his thing. And look, he still ended up getting traded. You get what I'm saying?
Hold on, Weasel.
You also had Mudiay. He was over there doing his thing in Denver. He ended up getting traded. You get what I'm saying? It's a reason why these players.
Jamal Murray.
You say what?
Point guard. Denver wanted to go with Jamal Murray at the point guard. That's why that got done.
But I'm saying, man, you can also use. I mean, ain't nothing wrong with keeping one of the two if you draft Ja Morant. That's all I'm saying. Because that'll give you a hell of a combination with either one of those guys. My thing is that if let's just say New York, if I'm thinking about it in this scenario, your team really don't have a solid foundation. You get what I'm saying? You really don't have a solid foundation to really build around. I mean, you got DeAndre Jordan at the center. So that's cool. Now you got a solid center.
You got him for the rest of the season. You got him for the rest of the year. So after next week, you don't know what you're going to do.
Right. So my thing is that I would start using some of these players that I have. You know, like a Noah Vonleh that came from the Bulls. You know what I'm saying? You got another big man, a Mitchell Robinson. New York got some quality players because I sat back and I watched them. I would start packaging up deals and building the team to make it much more sexier for that. Now, in your words, like you saying, it might be Kevin Durant or either Kyrie Irving coming over there. I would still package up some of these people to sexying up my team because New York ain't seen no good basketball in a while. You dig what I'm saying?
So you saying still draft Ja Morant?
I'm saying either way you go, even if you draft Ja Morant or either you say like Kyrie Irving or Kevin Durant, either way it go, I will package up some type of deal and use these players as assets because either way it go, they have no room. Even if Kyrie and Kevin Durant come over there, they have no room over there. Even if they draft Ja Morant, you drafting Ja Morant at number one, this is finna be your franchise. He not coming off the bench, so that means there's no room for them. So you take these players that's already been shown that they can play in this league and there's other teams out there like a Phoenix that got a number two pick or a number one pick or a number three pick or whatever pick is gonna be high. You also got another team like Chicago. You get what I'm saying? They got picks. I'm just naming teams right now that you got enough good quality players to where you can feel the needs of other teams, just like Sacramento do. Sacramento got a lot of good quality players to where you can feel the needs of other teams and build you a solid team so you can start making the push in the Western Conference or let's just say the Bulls, like I was mentioning, in the Eastern Conference. You get what I'm saying?
But this is what I'm saying. Let's just say, because the draft is before NBA free agency starts. So I'm saying, if you New York, you draft Ja Morant, and if Kyrie and Kevin Durant do come, you trade Ja Morant to New Orleans for Anthony Davis.
So get Anthony Davis in New York.
Yeah.
So if you draft Ja Morant, you're going to have to put a hell of a lot of package deal together, New York, in order to get Anthony Davis over there. And you talking about getting Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant. I'm speaking from what you're saying. It could be possible. I don't know. I mean, players are really like friends nowadays. They really not going to war in basketball. A little bit. They starting to do it a little bit, but... No, it really ain't like that, though.
I'm just saying, if I'm in New York, and I drive Ja Morant, and Kyrie and KD come.
Uh-huh.
I love Ja Morant. I would mind seeing him in New Orleans.
I would rather see him in a Bulls uniform.
I would too. But you just said
if you in New York,
you still drive.
I just basically gave a scenario on how to build your team up basically. That's basically all I'm doing, Weezy, was basically giving a scenario on how to build your team up. You get what I'm saying? Because evidently the players that they got now on the roster really didn't do good enough to get them a real good push towards a playoff spot. So, I mean, shit, why not make it a fire sale? That's all I'm saying.
Sure. Yeah, I got you. Sure.
I mean, man, what you got going on over there?
That's a baby.
Well, man, Joe, we're going to go on ahead. We're going to take a music break. This is Bring Your A-Game Sports Talk Radio Live. Me and my cousin Weezy, we sitting up here. We talking NCAA basketball. We talked about Ja Morant, you know, a little bit about the NBA draft and Zion Williamson. Man, we're going to go ahead and take a music break. Come back. We're going to talk. Man, we're going to talk about this Final Four when we come back, all right? You heard me? All right, man. We'll be back in y'all here. Bring Your A-Game Sports Talk Radio. And I'm just getting calls from everywhere, man. I can't believe this. Be back.
King Push. RZA. Razor Execution. The devil is a lie. You ain't broke bread till you taste the devil's pie. They say his laugh sounds like an angel when he cries. What better camouflage when the halo's your disguise? The wings don't fly, your traitor is your neighbor. At your front porch and he's handing you your paper. Bathrobe on, but the sword's underneath. And he wanna see your blood as it pours in the street. It's the mark of the beast. The meek shall inherit the earth. The weak shall inherit the dirt. You each should have perished at birth, still born or aborted. Every street tax gotta come with an audit. Either your life or your loved ones. Straight razor or a snub gun. From the village where the thugs from. Same corner that you copping all your drugs from. He a hero but he unsung. I'm the one.
Yeah.
I'm the one.
Hey, yo, homie, the chambers is 36, the new and improved, now make a move. These guns whistle, sizzle up, dudes who got big mouths, no power. Run of the bank with no dollars, got the nerve to switch crews. We better than the rest of them, I guess it's the estrogen. And all the money we got, we'll move like the Mexicans. A cartel, compound, a Carvel, a large scale of Scarsdale. I f*** with golf now, Shalaz L, yeah, the... It's fresh, straight out of Bermuda, yo. Or chillin' on the beach in Boca Chica with tuna. Salads and palaces, yo. We smoke out them chalices. Passing off balances of bread to the Allen since 1984. The f*** was just more. Then we would come through with rifles, rockin' night boots, then war. A real invention that came from a henchman who blew up. Now throw the woo up, that's my redemption.
Drug dealer, been that half my life. Drug dealer. Been that half my life. You talking, but you ain't never seen them. Imagine being first name basis with the kingpin.
God, I was Lucifer's neighbor. You wouldn't believe some of the things these people do for this paper. Moving with lasers under rubers. Make a move, you make the papers. Lose situation. Sweat of blood, you get to choose what you bathe in. The chemist cook work. The runner's footwork. The custies took work. The soldiers put work in on any one of the motherfuckers. To fuck up good work. Bosses tell them good work. That's just how the hood work. North Face bubble wit. 8 bundles under it. Go front upper lip smile while I was hugging it. I lied, I wasn't Lucifer's neighbor. He who I'm fuck with. My mom's threw that snow in her nose, but I would hustle it. Champ hoodie, mongoose with the pegs. Clap your stoop up, hit mom dukes in the leg. That's beef. Y'all ain't street. Y'all peep. Write it down and try to beat everything. Neck heavy swing, second hand swing.
swept across that pretty Bretling in that Nissan Honda Chevy thing, pedaling, whatever bring Fetty in steadily, I fed my whole team.
Drug dealer, been it half my life. Drug dealer, been it half my life. You talk it, but you ain't never seen them. Imagine being first name basis with the kingpin.
In this art of war, my paint stroke is Picasso. Get the picture, I ain't gotta paint the nostrils. You know my origin is over when fat black singing over organs. Die for a dollar, pride you don't swallow. You save that for the one you buying red bottoms. Yeah, that's the price you gotta pay for it. All's fair in love and war, she masquerade for it. Woo! Jack-o'-lantern push, trick or treat. I earned it off the books.
Bring your A-Game Sports Talk Radio right here on this Friday. What is today's date? Is today's day April the 4th? Today's day April the 4th, Weezy? Yeah, today's day April the 4th. No, today's day April the 5th, man. You just as crazy as me, man.
I just told you 5th.
Yeah, you just as crazy as me. Sitting up here in the player spot, sitting back chilling. April 5th is Friday. Free t-shirt giveaway. You dig? Me and my cousin Weasel, I'm just getting all type of texts and everything going on with my phone, man. But, yeah, we sitting back, we chilling, we talking, man. We're going to talk NCAA basketball for these next 10 minutes. Then I got to get up out of here. But easy for me to come back and get back on and continue this free t-shirt giveaway because I got a $50 Nike card I'm giving away. Gift card. BHIE Live. It'll be back online when I come back. So it's easy for me to hop on now, you know, get behind the video and do the thing. Even if Weasel available, he can call and talk, you know. But it's an all-out thing. We got the Final Four. We got Texas Tech, number 3, versus Michigan State, number 2. We're going to talk about that bracket first. Michigan State, let's go. Happy. My bracket's still alive. That's my championship team. Yeah, that's my championship team I got winning all. That's who I done had since like halfway through the season, since I seen how this boy Cassius Winston just his team was wasn't even all the way together all the way through the season. They had multiple injuries going on through that season, and I seen how this boy just put him on his back. And when they started to come back and come together, and I just seen how he just ran that team when they all just came back and how they just kept winning. I'm like, this is gonna be the champions, man. This is gonna be the champions right here.
So what's he saying? He carried them like Z-Bo did?
Yeah, he carried them like Z-Bo. You know, it was Big Zach. You know, that was T. Cleese, Big Zach, Mo Peterson. I mean, come on, man.
Jay Rich.
Joe Weasel, you don't know. I ain't got this going on. I ain't got the pictures, but I got my Michigan State hat on. I ordered me a Michigan State hat, and I'm rocking it right now. I'm rocking the champion, man. I can't wait for tomorrow, man. Hey, Bernie, it's cool because
you can't go outside with the hat on.
Hey, I've been outside. I've been working there. They went on, but it's cool though because everybody at my job, like about maybe about 5 or 6 of them, maybe 10 of them, they Michigan State alumni, man. So that's making the aura of everything feel good. Like Michigan State really gonna win it, man. I got a feeling they gonna beat Texas Tech, Joe. What you think?
I got a feeling
they'll
beat them too. Because of one person. Cassius.
Izzo. Yeah. Izzo gonna come back. Hey, listen. Cassius Winston is like a coach on that front. His court vision, his IQ is ridiculous. And people be talking about some, oh, he's slow. Oh, he can't do this. Listen here, I'll take that slow ass turtle over that fast ass rabbit any day because that slow ass turtle gonna be smart enough to get me to that finish line precise. And on time. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
I work at Player of the Year, man. That's what I think.
Do you think he'll get in the league?
Yeah, I think he's going to get in there. I see him playing more so of a Rondo role. Like, I can see Cassius Winston going to a team like San Antonio. You get what I'm saying? He need to be around that caliber of coach. That's gonna put him around.
I think he might need some weight.
That too.
You can't look like T.P. in the NBA, man. Come on.
I mean, you know when he get there, I'm quite sure they gonna put a weight on the training program to a point where they gonna make sure he slimmed down. I'm quite sure of that. They gonna do the same thing as Zion, even though Zion look like he didn't slim down, but. They're gonna do the same thing to him. I think Cassius Winston gonna be a damn good point guard, a very effective point guard on a team that's got like caliber pieces that's ready to go to the playoffs and hoop. You know what I'm saying? Like I say, I think San Antonio will be a good for him with Pop down there, cause Pop gonna let him do what he do. I mean, like I think. Now is he a top 5 pick? No, I think he a top 15. I think he most definitely is a top 15 pick. No bullshit. Top 20 at the least. What you think?
I think he might have to hit another year. Another year.
So if he won a championship, you say stay.
Yep.
No, I say you win a championship, you leave. You go out on top. That's when your game is at a high. Now it's time to get to that next level high. I say roll with that. But we both taking Michigan State or Texas Tech, right? We got Virginia and Auburn.
I'm taking Auburn.
That's what I got.
Auburn has already beat me last weekend. They can do.
I'm taking Auburn.
When you take two powerhouses?
Yeah.
And you still on top?
Yeah.
I got to go with you.
I'm taking Auburn. I'm Auburn. Auburn made me a believer because that boy guards, that boy Brown and Harper.
Yeah.
I mean they
even though they big boy is gone for the rest of the year.
What happened?
Remember he the one broke his leg last weekend.
I didn't see that game. That's why I asked what happened. I didn't see that game.
He broke his leg against Carolina.
Damn.
Yeah, he tore his ACL against Carolina.
Damn. And they still went out there and beat Kentucky 77-71 without him.
Well, they beat Carolina, I think, the rest of the second half without him.
Well, I just don't. Virginia's still a weak number to me. You get what I'm saying? Even though they made it to the final four, they still a weak number one. I don't think they enough fight with the whole with Auburn, man. And that's why I'm taking Auburn, because I don't know much about Auburn, but from what I done seen, like with the North Carolina game, but I didn't see the Kentucky game. I'm like, these boys gonna be a problem, Joe.
When you like the third team in the SEC, and the SEC was like the ACC this year, because you had Tennessee that was number one for a minute. You had Kentucky that was, I think they were number one for a minute. You had LSU in the top five, or probably top five some a little bit this year. Come on, man, you got it. Come on, man.
Yeah. But.
So
what you got? You ain't tell me. You said Auburn. You got Auburn. My fault. What you think about Virginia?
They put up
80 points against Purdue. It was 80-75. You had Guy, you know, that other guard in the room. The other guy, they had 24-25. I mean,
that's the most. I think that's the most Virginia put this year.
Was 80 points?
Majority of Virginia games was in the 60s.
Yeah, because they beat Oregon. They beat Oregon 53-49.
Because of their defense. Not saying the defense can't win championships, but come on, man. Nobody wants to get on.
So you take an Auburn because you think Virginia can't score much.
Right.
I did. I did wrong. I paid Virginia. I just know they ain't really a good spin that much. I'm going to be honest with you. Especially, I really think they should have won, but I'm not the one who make the decisions. I'm not the one who pull the strings. So, it is what it is. I'm the Auburn going. They would have been put out their misery. I can't pick Oregon to put them out their misery, but it didn't happen. So, oh well. Shit happens. But.
Mm-hmm.
We both got Auburn. Michigan. We're going to talk about who we got today. Because we both got Michigan, but we're going to wait after this 5-0 over. And then we're going to go back. Anyway. I'm going to go ahead and take a music break. Then come back. We're going to wrap up the show. And then, shit, we talk tomorrow before the game.
Okay. We can talk Zion after this? A little bit?
We can talk a little bit of Zion. We can fit some little Zion. We're going to fit about 3 minutes of Zion, then we're going to wrap up. We'll take a music break right now, all right?
All right.
Bring your game, Sprout Radio. I am the host of Kippy, sitting back talking on the phone with my cousin Weasel, man. I call him Jelly Back. Sitting back talking NCAA basketball, man. We talking about the Final Four, number 3 Texas Tech versus number 2 Michigan State. And then we got number 5 Auburn versus number 1 Virginia. Because we picked Michigan State. And I picked it, so we ain't gonna argue today, I guess. But Yo Cussy, featuring T.Y. for something. B.H.I.E. Live. My mind later on the day, around about the 8 o'clock hour. Be back in y'all here.
Yeah. 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 Bulletproof the windows, give me the fog lights. Riding with this lady tiger all night. Rolling on my left because my money always right. Created a legend with my life and I'm still gone. Coming down, still holding, steering wheel wood and my rims golden. Foreign scrapers to operate, you need a translator. Interior laid, you'd think I hired the decorator. Spectators wait and watch, anticipate each shot. From the top of the key, might stop and pop a 3, that's me. Ballin' Division 1, stunned at summer league. Park them big ass Hummers on the park, torch weave. I get money with a Porsche speed, rapidly stash and repeat. Cause I'm an athlete, training to maintain, ready to compete. These keys being released into the street. Fiends can't sleep, they listen till they OD. It's the sweetest thing, but at the same time it stings. Cash and diamonds got these peasants pretending to be kings. It ain't hard to tell, them diamonds real, but they rating very low on the scale. That's not clarity, that's just embarrassing. What type of jeweler carry those things? Get your motherfucking mind right.
Back on the air. It's all messing up. I don't know what the hell going on. We sitting back at 5 o'clock hour. Jelly Belly, you still there? Jelly Belly, you still there?
Yeah.
Okay. Sitting back in this 5 o'clock hour, like I was saying, man, we were talking AA basketball, so I'm messing up, so we're going to go on ahead and come in because we got to really wrap up the show. But you want to talk Zion. What Zion, what you want to talk about?
Hey, man, I think he's
cheating. Why you think that?
He does not want... He just knew in the situation he had to get lined up when the shoe blew out on him. And the next time that he could blow out, it might work than what it was. So what is that?
I get what you're saying. I'm saying. I mean...
Barrett needs to do this. Now you know you want to test me, but I'm out.
I mean, that's understandable, but you got to understand that Zion is a hooper, and you should know 100% with a Thurber Hooper. You know, one thing about them is winning and winning every level and then leave as a winner on that level. You get what I'm saying? It not to compare to Michael Jordan, but it's no different today. You get what I'm saying? Just want to compete. I'm not mad at the dude for that. You know what I'm saying? Because money ain't everything. And you can tell by the way the kid played. Like, I like Zion. But I think people put a lot of stock in him because I still see holes in his game that need to be worked on. And I can understand that he in college and his basketball IQ and skill level and ability is a little bit further past theirs. And I think that's what people get caught in the hype at. But at the same time, I still look at his overall game and then I look at what he got to match up on the next level in the NBA. And I see like, okay, this dude really need to work on this and he really need to work on that because whatever franchise he go to, they going to put that number one spot and that number one slot on him. You get what I'm saying? And I don't want him to get to that next level and fail. I just want him to be equipped. And by him with Duke, I don't think that coach is going to equip him like that. You get what I'm saying? So, I mean, you got to understand the hooping and the competitive spirit of him. You know, that's what I respect. That's what I respect more about Zion Williamson, man. He a hoop. You know what I'm saying? He an old school type of hooper at that.
I got
you,
but I'm saying, this is that you care about the kid. All he cares about is the
point.
I mean, how much money can probably make on him for that 1 year?
That could be true. But I say, do whatever's best for you, young fella. I mean, the money in the NBA is good. At the same time, this kid is still only like 18 years old, man. Maybe he not ready for that fast lifestyle right now. You know, maybe he not ready for that world right now, and I think some people might gotta expect, and basketball is his world and his freedom, and right now, you know, this is really his first time away from home, probably, at high school. He probably just ain't ready. He probably know he ain't ready, but at the same time, he know that he can win on collegiate level, and by being put out, you know, Duke always going to have a high draft class. That's what come in next year. He the veteran. Now they feed off his energy. And maybe Duke be a little bit better. You get what I'm saying? Think about it like that. Think about that. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, I mean, we're going to go on here. Talk to Zion. Ja Morant. We're going to wrap the show. Weezy, you got shout-outs? Anything you want to say? Gonna mention about Rod anything?
Just hoping that he gets back
to being 100%. Yeah, that's our cousin Rod, man. He ain't got out of the hospital. And how long he been in the hospital?
Since January 6th,
and we in April, and he just coming home. I just let you know, man. It is a God out there, man. It is a God out there, man. And he do bless the righteous because Rod a good dude, man. But before we go, something that means it means something to me, man. The homie Nipsey Hussle, yo, man. That it's more than just me being a fan of his music, man. This dude and like. He's a good dude, man. This is something that like really hurt, and it really hurt a lot of black people because you seen a young man that grew up in a hood that was very intelligent, come up with basically $1 billion plan to make where he grew up better. That's the image that's the image that white America don't want you to see. And I'm gonna just leave it at that, man. But rest in peace, Nipsey Hussle, man, Joe. As my word right here, bitch, I ain't gonna do that part to keep your dream alive, man, and everybody else who dream you was trying to keep alive, man. We out, we done. Until tomorrow. BHIE Live. Bring your game, Sports Talk Radio. I'm your host, the Black Hippie. I'm done.